This is Keandre Jones, and you're watching Sit Downs with JaMir.
Episode of Sit Downs with JaMir. I'm here with the 28th ranked ESPN 300 player, number two player in the state, outside linebacker, Under Armour All American, Keandre Jones. Good Counsel.
How you doing, bro?
Good, bro. South Germantown alumni. We go back, so you know, I just had to link up with my man here, and we're gonna talk a little bit, learn about him today. All right. When can you first recollect your love for football?
I mean, it just goes back to show, you know, you guys came here today, me working out on the field not too long ago. I was in the weight room, I just had a passion for just working out, and I recall fourth grade, fifth grade year, I started playing football at Maplewood.
Okay.
And this little organization growing up was dominant at the time, and then it grew to South Germantown. Mm-hmm. With alumni, so okay. It grew there, and then Rockville Lions, of course, with you know, playing footballs from a private school league, and introducing me to, you know, private school life, and me becoming a Good Counsel student and graduating, which led me to, you know, Ohio State. So it's been a blessing. Football has definitely impacted me in a major way, and I'm glad that, you know, I was able to start it my fourth and fifth grade year.
Okay, so let's take it back to, you know, coming up. So you know, before Good Counsel, who was really in your corner, you know, backing you up, you know, being there for you?
Of course, you guys know, like I said, South Germantown alumni, Coach Xavier Twine has impacted me in a major way, just bringing me as a youth, just bringing me under his wing, picking me up from practice every day, whatever it is, food, whatever, rides back and forth, game times. Give me cleats and stuff, just looking out for me like I was one of his own sons. So that was definitely big and an encouragement in me developing and taking my talents to where I'm at now. So, yeah, shout out to Coach Zay.
Coach Zay, yeah. You know, my senior night for football at Seneca Valley, he walked out with my parents.
That's dope.
He walked me out. So, I mean, he's had a huge influence on me. Again, shout out to Coach Zay. He's such a big staple in the Germantown organization. And, you know, we can't say enough about him. He's our guy. You know, you gave him your Under Armour.
Yeah, personally, it was an honor to give him my Under Armour All-American jersey. Just recently, we had dinner and just talked about me coming up as a, you know, youth to now, like a young adult, young man, and growing and going off to Ohio State. So it's
right.
Definitely cool to have handed him my Under Armour All-American jersey.
All the things he does for the kids.
The organization for Germantown.
Off the field. It's not just, you know, coaching
crazy.
And going home. You know
exactly.
What I'm saying?
The community.
It's more than football. It's a community. It's growing, making sure these young guys like myself don't make the wrong decisions in life and stay committed to just working hard, staying focused. And he's bringing them in his house, feeding them, whatever he needs. Like, he's a big impact on this community. So, shout out to Coach Zay.
Shout out to Coach Zay. How did you come to your decision to go to a private school instead of a public school and to come here specifically?
Growing up, you know, my seventh grade year, I was introduced to like the private school league and playing with the Rockville Lions,
okay.
This you know, local organization. It helped me to open my eyes up to new things I never seen, like Good Counsel, Gonzaga, St. John's, DeMatha, of course. And of course, Good Counsel caught my eye, and I just went with the big school at the time. You know, they were undefeated, had won like three WCAC championships in a row. I wanted to make a forthcoming in my freshman year, so it was big picking Good Counsel, coming to a dominant school at the time, and carrying on that tradition. So it's definitely cool, you know, graduated from here.
Okay, so everyone knows on the outside looking in how great of a program it is. So can you tell me a little bit of insides of, you know, experiencing Good Counsel, you know, as yourself? What did you love about it?
Just looking around, it's like a college campus. I mean, you're going to get a college atmosphere. The game times is like a college feel. A lot of fans, a lot of intensity,
passion.
We work hard just like a college team would. Coaching, we train and education-wise is phenomenal. So. I mean, we're just preparing, it prepares you for college. And I think, you know, with me leaving this weekend for the Ohio State University, you know, it's definitely preparing me for the next level. So I'm ready to take my talents and just keep developing as a player and grow and mature and learn different things that, you know, maybe Good Counsel missed on. And just exploring and expanding.
Continuing to grow. Yeah. That's what it's all about.
Definitely.
So, you know, we're talking about the Ohio State, you know what I'm saying? So it's, you know, the allure, the history, the championships, the professional players. You know, I'm sure the school sells itself, but specifically, what drew you to that school?
We talked about development in the beginning of our interview, so that in itself, they develop their players not just for football, but life after football. A lot goes into the player and working out and doing stuff on the field, but they really focus on the character and developing their players for the real world. So let's say football goes away, because, you know, we all can't play football for right. that long, and, you know, certain things happen. So it drew me towards, you know, life after just growing and maturing as a man, the business aspect of Ohio State. They job opportunities right away. As soon as I enter campus, they were talking about, you know, we can set you up, you know, put you in a position, good position to have a future after football. So it's definitely important to focus and have a plan B just in case football, you know, doesn't work out, because football doesn't work out for everybody. So
okay, so Urban Meyer, I mean, he's one of the biggest coaches in the country. He's well documented as one of the best coaches, in my opinion, one of the best coaches as well. What's your relationship with him? How did he, you know, start the relationship, and how are you continue to build with him?
Just coming off of playing for Coach Bob Malloy from Good Counsel, you're playing for a legendary coach, a coach that loves to win, a lot of tradition, a lot of intensity, integrity. Coach Myers holds in his background, and just playing for him is unbelievable. He came here to visit me when I committed. Mm-hmm. Got to meet the family, friends, and just a good guy. You gotta get around, you gotta get a feel for him.
Uh-huh. I heard you got a nickname for him.
Boss man. Shout out to you, Boss man.
Okay, I heard he got a nickname for
you.
Yeah,
he called me Special K. He said that's the only name calling me. Nobody else can't call me that.
Special K, we got Special K here. So you get selected as Under Armour All American, and we all see it on ESPN. We see the practices, we see the past professional players taking part in that as high school seniors. How was that experience? Let us know some insight, you know, about that experience, that week and that game going against, you know, the best players in the country.
Leading up to the UA game, that's like my off season we're going to talk my off season from the championship game, you know, coming off the loss to the Mather. It was heartbreaking, but you move on, you prepare for the next steps in your lives. So the UA game came, and it's an honor, it's a blessing, and I'm very, very humbled to even receive that, because a lot of guys all over the country would die to be in that position. So you just take advantage of it. Took the plane down to Florida, practice, long days. It's not just a game where you can just go out there and fool around, you know. Right. So you got to put in the work. You know, we practice, intensity,
competing.
You're going against the best of the best, so you don't want to get embarrassed. And you know, you play football, you know what it is. It's a lot of trash talking, it's a fast
it's
game.
Big.
It's big time football.
Yeah, everybody wants to show up.
It doesn't get any bigger than the UA game, so it's a blessing.
Mm-hmm. Okay, so what other, you know, I'm sure you traveled around. If we get some, you know, he told us he got these from Oregon.
Yeah.
Especially from my name, Phil Knight.
Yeah.
You know, he hand delivered them to him, I guess.
Nothing like that, but it's definitely, these were from the Oregon opening, one of the camps that I got to attend as a senior before my senior season. And they blessed us with a lot of Nike gear. And like I said, that's another blessing on blessing. I just thank the man above. It just keeps delivering good stuff my way, and I keep repaying just by with hard work. So
you see, Ohio State, you know, they have a bunch of players drafted in the first round, a bunch of players drafted, you know, in all the rounds. You know, you see a bunch of Ohio State alum. You know, when they do the starting lineups, the Ohio State University in the NFL Sunday night, Monday night games. Do you envision yourself one day becoming one of those players, hearing your name called on draft day and playing in the NFL one day?
that's a dream of mine. That's why I work so hard day in and day out. That's why I'm here 7 a.m. in the morning to 8 o'clock at night. I don't go home. And then on top of that, you know, you have homework still, maybe a paper here and there to do. So I definitely imagine myself in that league. And that's my plan A. Never give up on your plan A. And that's something I dedicate myself to. And that's a real job to me, because we work day in and day out to prepare for, you know, our future and, you know, college, the weight room, on the field, academically. We prepare. It's like a job, but we're not getting paid yet.
Yeah.
And the league, NFL, is that's where we can, that's our reward, and that's how we, you know, as athletes, that's what we get. That's our reward. And I definitely prepare myself day in and day out to make that my goal.
Good. All right, so can you talk about, a little bit about your mom, you know, her influence and showing her strength and what she's gone through? Can you talk a little bit about that?
Yeah, anybody who knows me personally on a personal level knows that my mom is my biggest motivation, and this is why I play the game so violently and passionate, you know, with a lot of passion. And everything I do is for her, just working hard, her hard work, her sacrifices, day in and day out. She makes sure that I'm okay and I'm in good position and even in good spirits, you know, whether she's going through something or not, she's going to make sure I'm okay first before anything. So I put her before anything. Football, doesn't matter what it is, she's my biggest motivation, biggest supporter. Senior night was one of the best nights, just to see her smiling, and, you know, I think she cried that night. Mm-hmm. So, you know, it was definitely, anytime she gets really emotional, I know that, you know, I'm touching her, I'm doing something right, I'm, you know, doing what I need to do, as far as being a young man and her being a single mother, just being there and doing it, you know, going to school every day, doing my homework, just graduating. Because a lot of kids don't get that opportunity. Mm-hmm. And it's a lot of single mothers out there that don't know how to handle being on their own and raising a young man without a man in the household. And I just matured way more than I ever could with her being so strong.
Of course.
So, yeah, she's definitely a big impact, stronger than anything in this world, and means so much to me. And I just can't wait to keep supporting her.
You know, I see you got family over everything right here.
This is my newest addition to the family. And then I got Hope on this arm with the breast cancer sign. Shout out to my grandmother. She's still alive. She survived it. She overcame it twice. Okay. So
you just got a family full of fighters, man.
Yeah, so it's definitely cool. Mm-hmm. It's definitely cool to have have a support system like that backing you up.
Motivation,
definitely.
They didn't never stop, and you ain't never going to stop.
Never.
We know that already. Wrapped up senior year. You had prom. Tell me a little bit about that. I heard a special story after prom. But, you know, how was, you know, getting dressed up, getting all
flying stuff? Yeah, leading up to the prom, you know, like I said, I'm a mama's boy, so when I'm getting dressed, I like to, you know, just ask her for her opinion, because she's a lady, she's a female. Female knows what's right, what's wrong. So she's dressing me, she's put on the bow tie for me. Put on the jacket for me. And nowadays, you know, cell phone's out. She wants to take a picture every minute. Mm-hmm. So we're taking pictures left and right. During the evening, we get on the boat, a big old yacht, and a lot of food, dancing. We don't get off the boat until like 11, come back here, Good Counsel. Like I said, it's a college campus, so we get treated like, you know, we're royalty here.
Right.
So we have like a nice little carnival thing. Mm-hmm. And, you know, we stayed there till like 11 from 3 o'clock.
Right.
And we just sitting there on the moon bounce. It's a limbo tournament going on.
Uh-huh.
And music playing. And me and my best friend, we decided, you know, join the limbo, because, you know, we're feeling ourselves.
Right.
So we go, it's this high. We start playing around with it. Okay. We go on. And we see it keeps getting lower. And we're hanging in there with, you know, the smaller kids. I'm 6'2".
Mm-hmm.
I'm 6'2", so it's getting tough. But I'm hanging in there. I'm feeling it. I'm vibing to the music. I'm going down there, and it's down to the last two, me and my best friend, Trayvon Stott, that's going to Maryland. Shout out to Trey.
Shout out to Trey.
It's me and him, and we get down to the last, like, almost the last limbo, uh-huh, you know, stick thing. So, you know, we're going down. Trey goes first, he fails. So like the whole crowd, like we got a crowd. It looks like we, you know, we having a battle.
So it's getting intense.
It's getting real intense.
People don't know limbo can get real.
Definitely, if you're an athlete, you gotta compete.
It don't matter what it is.
It does not matter. So you know, it comes down to the last us two, and he fails. I got the whole crowd looking on. So you know, I got impressed. So you know, I'm feeling the music, I'm vibing to it, getting low. I gotta show you guys the pictures. It's crazy, but I end up winning the limbo tournament. Trey's a runner up. He gets two gift cards too. I get two gift cards to Subway and Regal, the movies. So it was cool. Okay. I had to enjoy my last prom with my best friends and just I went out in style. So
that's how it's supposed to be. Your senior year in the cap and gown. How was that? And where did y'all graduate?
It was in D.C. at the Basilica, up in So we were there for 4 hours, I believe, because we're a Catholic school. We do a nice little big mass ceremony. A lot of people there. A lot of cameras out. A lot of speakers. Alumni from back from like 1965.
Wow.
Yeah, one of my coaches actually was there. He spoke. Shout out to Bob Clark, Coach Clark. What else? I mean, just a lot of your family, friends are there. And of course, after you go out to eat with your family and friends, and you know, you do your last send off with your friends, and you know, last goodbye or see you later. You know, depending on how the relationships you built the last 4 years at Good Counsel. So it's definitely an honor graduating from Good Counsel.
It happens fast, man.
It definitely does.
Next thing you know, you come in here as a freshman. Next thing you know, you walking out as a
grown
senior, grown man, becoming a young man. You know, anything else you want to talk about? Anything else?
It's been an honor, you know, just to grow in the school, in this community, and stick and stay friends, you know, in contact with you guys. And JaMir, I appreciate you so much, dude.
Of course.
You know, best of luck to you in the future, and just keep doing what you're doing, grinding, hard work, and yes, appreciate it. This is Keandre Jones, the Ohio State University outside linebacker, and I'm sitting down with JaMir.